Tables are a quick and easy way to organize information. From data, to categories, to statistics, tables can keep it all straight. I bet when most of you hear the word table, you think of a combination of lines, creating squares or sections. My name is Kit, and today I'm here to show you that tables can be much more. On a Mac computer, it is easy to access tables using Microsoft Word. To insert a basic table onto a blank page, simply move your cursor to the toolbar and select the Tables option. A small grid will then appear. If you move your cursor diagonally, the table chart will expand. Simply decide how many rows and columns are needed, and then select the same number on the grid. Remember to include the header in this number. You will find yourself with a basic table. However, if you wish to make a table from scratch, select the Table option from the top bar of your screen. Then select the first option, which reads Draw Table. After selecting this option, your cursor should change to look like a pencil. You would then be able to draw a rectangle or square to be the size that you prefer. You would then also be able to draw lines horizontally and lines vertically to create the columns and rows that you wish. If you wish to add columns after your table is already created, simply place your cursor in the column where you wish to create more. The new column will appear on the right or left of where you place your cursor. Then move your cursor up to the Tables option on the top of your screen and select. On the menu that is displayed, select Insert. A separate menu will appear. Then you can select column to the right or column to the left. A new column are created. You can create new rows as well using the same option. Simply select the option Rows Above or Rows Below, and new rows are created. If you wish to add shading to your table, move your cursor to select the Tables menu. At the bottom of the menu will be an option called Table Properties. After selecting this, then find the button that reads Borders and Shading. You can then choose to shade a specific section with any color you wish, or you can shade the whole table. For this example, we will shade the whole table. Select OK, and your table will shade. I encourage you to play around with the shading options. You will find that there are endless possibilities. Another great option when making a table is to select Quick Tables. When you select this, many images of pre-made tables pop up. You can then select the table that best works for you, or that you prefer, and add it into your Word document. For the brave and experienced, there's also the complex table option. This option includes calendars that can be inserted, or many complicated tables. Here are a few examples. Feel free to explore these more on your own. You can adjust the number of rows and columns in your table. You may add rows and columns by the methods mentioned previously. You can also delete rows and columns by right-clicking on the column or row that is not needed and selecting Delete Cells. After this is selected, a menu instantly appears, listing options such as Shift Cells Left, Shift Cells Up, Delete Entire Row, or Delete Entire Column. These can be selected when appropriate. Tables can be very useful when teaching. For an example, they can be used to keep track of your student's schedule, like the table that is green. They can also be used to keep track of course activities. They can be used to organize your lesson plans or plan activities. They are a quick and easy way to add structure to your classroom and to your life. I hope that you have learned a lot about tables today. Thanks for listening.